Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Kocher. The New Hampshire legislature is on the way home, but they've done some work and some pretty good work. Let's look at some of that work they've done. State budget, more but not enough. $10.7 billion in spending over 2 years. Actually, they've got a budget surplus of $6.9 million. No casino gambling, though, and no Medicaid expansion. Now, the big winner, New Hampshire businesses, increasing the business enterprise tax credit carry forward, increasing the reporting thresholds for business enterprise tax, increasing the net operating loss cap, $1 million to $10 million, and overhauling the New Hampshire Corporations Act and increasing the research and development tax credit. Now, here's some general increases. University System of New Hampshire and the Community College System both got some of their money back. Land and Community Heritage Investment Program, the cities and towns, developmentally disabled and the mentally ill, and the state police. And then here are some of the cuts. Health and Human Services, the judicial branch, the New Hampshire Veterans Home, and state personnel. With me to talk about this is somebody who knows the legislature pretty well, David Juvet, who is Senior Vice President of the Business Industry Association of New Hampshire. Welcome.
Thank you, Fred.
Nice to have you here. This is the most bipartisan legislature I think I have seen in years, especially on the budget. Only 18 people in the House have voted against the compromise budget that came out of the conference committee. What happened?
I don't know. I've been working this legislature since 1990, and this is the first budget I can remember that had so much support, both from the Republicans and Democratic Party. It was really pretty extraordinary.
Well, let's go down the business items in particular, but I want to ask you at the end about casino gambling and Medicaid expansion, because they didn't make it. Increasing the business enterprise tax credit carry forward.
Yeah, there were three tax issues that were passed by the past legislature, the last session, but not scheduled to go into effect until the fiscal year that starts July 1st. And one of them was an increase in the BET carry forward from 5 years to 10 years. Another was the threshold amount, the amount that small businesses have to meet before they pay the BET. Mm-hmm. And the third was an increase in the net operating loss cap from $1 million to $10 million. That particular one benefits the manufacturing sector.
And the others affect just about everybody.
Raising the BET threshold is especially important for small businesses, startup businesses, and increasing the BET carry forward is important for those businesses that have varying business cycles and may not be able to use that credit all in 1 year.
And then the overhaul of the New Hampshire Corporations Act, which is something the BIA took a lead on, and that really is how you govern your company.
Yeah, that is long overdue. Our Corporation Act is over 20 years old. New Hampshire was really behind the curve, very difficult to attract corporations to this state to domicile here with an old act. So we did a complete rewrite, and now the governor signed that bill this past week. New Hampshire has the newest, most modern Corporation Act of any state in the country.
And of course, the R&D tax credit, the cap went from $1 million to $2 million. Now, let me ask you about some things that didn't get done that the governor was hoping for. Casino gambling, where are we on that?
Well, that's pretty dead, I think. If it was going to pass, it would have passed this year, and it was clear that there was not the support in the House, even with the governor's strong support and strong Senate support. Hard to see how that passes next session.
Okay, and Medicaid expansion, they decided to study it. Why?
Yeah. Well, that had the support of the governor and the support of the House. It did not have the support of Senate Republicans, who thought the issue needed more study. And they're going to get it. They're going to do a special commission looking at Medicaid expansion over the next 3 months. They have to submit a report by October 15th, and there's a chance we could see a special session on that issue before the end of the year.
It's about 58,000 people in the state who would benefit from that.
And about $2.5 billion in federal funding.
And $2.5 billion in federal funding, and you have a business concern with that, right?
Well, from the business perspective, we're concerned about cost shifting when the state doesn't fully fund Medicaid.
Right.
And we're a little unsure how expanding the Medicaid base will impact that. We don't know that it'll happen, but we're not certain, and so we're looking forward to the study, too.
The state budget in 5 minutes. David Juvet, Senior Vice President of the Business Industry Association of New Hampshire. Thanks. And if you want to see this interview again, go to WMUR.com, click on News, and then click on Project Economy.